Cropping images is sometimes needed, but we lose pixels if we crop. Luckily, there is a solution, Topaz Gigapixel AI, which just got much better. Let's see how much better. Hi, it's Peter here. And a disclaimer. Topaz Labs do not sponsor this video. I have bought all the Topaz software I have. However, I do have affiliate links to Gigapixel AI if you're interested in getting it. This video is based on Gigapixel AI 6.3.3. And a spoiler alert, answer to the question how much better? Well, a lot better. What has been upgraded? Let's dive in and see what Topaz says about the upgrade. The major changes are improved standard model with new architecture, new HQ model for high quality input images, fixed compression slider for the controllability over blocky processing or compression artifacts in standard and HQ mode. Or models, actually, that's what they call them. Other changes and fixes. Faster first time model loading speed on max. Fixed phase recovery processing failures on specific NVIDIA GPU models. Reduced crashes on Intel GPUs and UI fixes. Preview idle comparison view on view selection, for example. I will discuss these and test how it compares to the older architecture. Better upscaling for HQ and AI generated images. What caught my eye was the word AI generated images. I need to see this and test an image I created with AI. By the way, playing around with AI image generation is a lot of fun. As you can see here, these AI generated images are much better when upscaled, when I have upscaled them with Gigapixel AI. Is the new version better than the older one? Here is an example, and yes, it is much better. There's a vast difference. It looks like Topaz has added some features from Photo AI. Most likely, there is something similar to that architecture under the hood regarding enhancements. As you see from the result, it is worth upgrading. If your license has expired, renew it. It might be a wise thing to do. The new version is much better than the old one. Luckily, I still have my license valid until next August. I have an affiliate link in the description if you want or need to buy Gigapixel AI or renew your license. After discussing the tools, I will compare the results with Photo AI later in this video. And let's talk about the tools. The new fixed compression slider controls the compression artifact removal. It is available in standard and HQ models. And AI models, which one to use? You can let Gigapixel automatically choose the best AI model, or you can choose it yourself. A good starting point is standard model. It can handle most images quite well. Topaz Labs recommends using HQ if the image you are upscaling is high quality. And in this case, high quality means technical quality, of course. Which one is better, standard or HQ? I could not find any differences in the images I tested. The results are quite similar. You might want to test yourself and see how it is with your images. The other AI models are Lines, Art and CG, low res, and very compressed. Lines is good for architecture, cityscapes, typography, and images with thick lines. Art and CG is good for images that are not photographed. Low resolution is best for images with blocky compression artifacts. Very compressed is for images with a lot of compression artifacts, old digital files and similar. Old scans could be something. If you scan images, that could be also used for that. And then let's talk about the settings here. There are three settings. Suppress noise, remove blur, and fix compression. Suppress noise will reduce noise in the image. It works okay, but there are other alternatives if you want only to reduce noise. Topaz Denoise AI, for example. Remove blur will do what it says. Make blurry images sharper. Here again, Topaz Sharpen AI is a better tool for this. The fixed compression is something that makes the image a lot better, and that's something that you should play around and see what is best for your image. Here you can see an example of 100% before and after. It is upscaled 4 times. This low quality underexposed image looks too plasticky, but I think it is still better than the original when I have applied the Gigapixel AI models. And then there are some additional settings. Face recovery will detect faces and remove artifacts. Here is an example. I took a phone selfie this morning. There is much to recover in this face, but I do not think Gigapixel AI did an outstanding job. My face looks unsharp and plastic. Turn on the gamma correction for really colorful images. And here is an example of a really colorful image. I added saturation and vibrance to the image to make it even more saturated. The image on the left is without gamma, and the one on the right is gamma on. The one with gamma on is sharper and has less color bleeding. How does Gigapixel AI compare to Photo AI? In Photo AI, Topaz has combined their AI software into one. Photo AI has noise reduction, sharpening, enhancements, and upscaling. Do you still need other software like Gigapixel AI? The short answer is yes. The result from Gigapixel AI is a lot better. Photo AI is an excellent software if you need to enhance images and make it look technically better. The workflow is so much smoother. If you need to upscale your image, I suggest using Gigapixel AI and the newest version 6.3.3. Here you can see the difference. I do not need to explain this. You can see the difference. But does this make Photo AI obsolete? No, not at all. It is still very usable for enhancements and noise reduction. As I already mentioned, the workflow is nice and smooth. You do not have to think in what order you need to make the enhancements. Photo AI will figure that out. If you're interested in Gigapixel AI or other Topaz software, use the affiliate links down below. You will support my free content. You do not pay any extra, of course, but I will get a small cut from the price. As I said, Topaz Photo AI is also an excellent software to enhance your images. And here is my video about it, or it's actually over that side. But hey, thanks for watching and bye for now.